So I'm not going to answer a should question. I'll answer it factually, and you can determine the should from the factual. Okay. So when you talk about game style, there's all these different sort of. Do you guys play video games? Yeah, some of you guys. So one type of video game that I'll play is there's like the video game where you have certain characters that have like attributes, and then you play the character with the attributes, right? And I've done this in the context of sports games mainly, but whatever. So you have you're playing some like soccer game, and this player has like 84 speed and like 72 shooting and whatever, right? And these are the attributes, right? And different good player or different good characters in the game or whatever will have a different set of attributes, but they're all overall like kind of high. There's ranges that kind of work, right? So think of yourself as a character in game kind of that way, where you have certain attributes, right? So you have your assertiveness level, and there's like maximum assertive, where like you're just like walking out trying to pick a fight with every person in the world, right? There's like minimum assertive, where like you would never do a cold approach, and if a girl like talked to you, you'd like shy away and run to a corner. Right? And then there's a range in the middle that's kind of good, right? And there's a range in the middle that's good game, right? Now, I don't care where you fall in that good range, but if you're outside that good range, your game's gonna fail, right? If you're way, way, way too assertive to the point that nobody likes you, your game's gonna fail. If you're too unassertive that you never make a move, your game's gonna fail. But there's a range, and it's a pretty wide range of what could be effective assertiveness levels in game, right? Similarly, in terms of amount of flirting, like quantity of flirting, there's too much flirting where you're a cartoon or where you're cheesy and a total player. There's not flirting enough where you're totally platonic and a girl can't feel any attachment to you. And then there's a range in between. And there's this kind of banded range that is good game. And I don't care for each of you where in that banded range you fall, but you need to be in that range. Introversion, extroversion, right? If you're way, way, way too extroverted, nobody's gonna take you seriously. You're never gonna settle in on a target. You're never gonna build an actual connection with one girl. If you're way too introverted, you're never going to do an approach. The girl's friends aren't going to like you, et cetera, et cetera. But there's a range of introversion, extroversion that is good and optimal for game. And I've seen guys that are way at the introverted range of that good game that are very good. I've seen guys that are way at the extroverted range of that good game that are very good. But if you go outside of it, you're no longer there, right? And so in terms of thinking about what you want to develop for yourself, just think about being in the right range on all these things. But then within that range, you should reflect your own personality. And by the way, your game should make you happy, right? Every single guy I know who's really good in game, they have very different approaches, very different types of girls they like, very different types of relationships they like, and their game style starts to suit that, right? There are some guys that they just want to get to the point, they don't want any bullshit. And so they will be super abrasive in their game, and they'll just be like, I'm just going to do what the fuck I want, I'm going to be a total asshole, I'm going to get all the objections out up front, and the girl's either gonna blow me out in 5 minutes or I'm gonna pull her. And that's it. And they're like actually like trying to provoke shit tests and trying to provoke as much battle as possible so that they just know at the start and they just don't waste their time. There are other guys that are much more subtle and they'll be very like, you know, little adjustment here, little adjustment here, nice pleasant conversation, which is a little sprinkle of game, and that's their style. And for them, that's a guy maybe in terms of the type of guy that would want that kind of game. Certain guys hate failing at game, so to speak. So they don't care, they don't mind if they spend the entire night with a girl and then they end up just taking a phone number. But what they don't want is they hate failing sets. So they just want the highest percentage of I talk to this girl and that ratio goes to sex or to a relationship or whatever, right? And that's a very different game approach than the like very abrasive up front, love me or hate me and then we're done approach, right? The love me or hate me or done approach is much more effective for if I want to pull a high frequency of nights. But the other one's much more effective if I want to pull a high frequency of sets, right? And let's say you have a very particular type of girl, right? Of that girl, there's maybe 10 in the entire world. You wouldn't want the like, you know, abrasive blow me or blow me out type of game with those 10 girls. You might want to finesse it a little bit and give yourself a better chance because you're really going after quality over quantity, right? So different people have that kind of stuff. Other guys really like a lot of banter in their interactions and they encourage banter. Other guys like a lot of sweetness and they like getting to know the girl in their interaction and that's what they go with, right? And so again, your game is going to reflect your preferences, right? Also the venues you go to, the girls you choose to talk to, all of that's gonna reflect your preferences. But there's no right or wrong, right? I mean, I'm lying. There's absolutely right or wrong. But there's no right or wrong as long as you're in the ranges. Like there's no right or wrong place within that band of successful game for you to be.